It came! It finally came! The big one.
Hi friends, welcome back to my channel. In this video, I'm gonna attempt to do a reading vlog of Crooked Kingdom by leigh barudgo. Now, last week, or two weeks ago, I finished reading Seas of Crows, and if you follow me on Instagram, or if you just know me, then you know that I love this book. I gave it 5 stars on Goodreads, and I tagged quite a lot, I would say, and I felt a void in my heart after I finished this, and I knew that, you know, I had to wait for this, but oh, look how beautiful they are. These are the collector's edition, and I love them. It's about 6 people going on a heist, but yeah. So I'm gonna read Six of Crows, nope, Crooked Kingdom, and I'm gonna try and film myself reading this. Like, I don't know how people do reading vlogs. Like, do they just film constantly of them reading? Because I know, like, some, like, with this at least, like, some chapters didn't have much going on versus other chapters. I will figure it out. But, oh, this book took me like a week to read, which for some people that might be a lot, but for me, I'm a slow reader. 14-year-old me would be so disappointed, because I remember reading The Order of the Phoenix in 4 days, and that book is like 700 pages. Where's that girl? I miss her. Before I go, I know what's gonna happen in this book. That's why I kind of want to do a reading vlog about it, because I want to capture my reaction. I know what will go on. Like, non-spoilery, but I know what's gonna happen, and I'm ready for my heart to get ripped out. Yeah. Okay. Let's go! So, an update. It is now 1 a.m. I have not read anything. I wanted to show you, like, what I used to annotate, which is not very exciting, but I thought you guys wanted to know. In this book, I actually had to switch pens throughout the book because it was starting to, like, the pen I used was running out of ink, so I switched to a much bolder pencil, pen. I don't know if you can see. So yeah, I will continue to use that pen, and then I use a highlight to literally highlight my highlights. Okay. So okay. Just thinking back to this book. Okay, anyway, so I use this pen. It came in a pack of 3, and then I have a mylaner. This is the gray one. So yeah, I have those, and then I have my reading journal, or my reading and watch journal. And here I just store my bookmark and my tabs. These tabs, my friend Hannah actually recommended, or I saw that she had those on her Instagram, and I was like, ooh, I like those. Those are thin. But the only thing though is that because the whole thing is like solid color, when you put it in the book, it's kind of hard to read. Especially if you place it over a sentence. So I do want to see if I can't find those that are like clear, and then just a little piece at the end is colored. So we'll see. So those are what I use. As for the annotation itself, it's not really interesting. I don't color code my tabs. I know that Hannah does that. She also likes to match the tab to her cover. I am not that ambitious. And what I annotate, or what I mark, is really just thing that makes me go okay. So for example, like, do I want to spoil, I mean, this book is quite old, But if you do want to go into this blank, don't watch this, I guess. Okay, so here. See, I underlined and I marked. So it says, on the northern ice, his choices had seemed clear, but now his thoughts were muddied with these thugs and thieves, with Agnes's courage and Jasper's daring, and with Nina. Always Nina. And I, of course, had to highlight because my Hellenic heart. Okay, so I think I'm gonna read like one chapter because the chapters are really short. I think that's why it also didn't take me that long to read, because I felt like I just had to continue reading since it was so short. But it is 1 a.m. I already read this part, so I'm gonna skip it. One chapter. It was like 11 pages. Okay, actually, I think I'm gonna stop there because it is a couple of pages and I am sleepy. So, see you tomorrow, I guess. So I just finished the second chapter and I need to go out so I can't read more, but I'm not sure if I want to bring the book or not because it is quite big. I know when I read Six of Crows, I didn't bring it out in the beginning, but when I came like halfway, I couldn't put it down, so I ended up bringing it out. Okay, I'll update you guys whenever I read more. Crooked. That is very fitting, very fitting. Okay, so if you recognize this background, you're a real one. But I'm at my parents' house. I'm here for the weekend. I of course brought the book. Time I read, I finished part one, and not much have happened, like as of yet, but. We have tabs. Yeah. Let's just read. See how far we come. Okay. So I haven't been reading for like 2 days now, so I'm still halfway through the book, and I kind of feel bad because it took me a week to finish Six of Crows, but it's taking me a little longer to finish Crooked Kingdom, and that's not the book's fault. I'm just a slow reader, especially when I have to work and stuff. It's just reading is not my number one priority, but I'm gonna try to read. So now it is 11 p.m. And I'm kind of tired because I just got back home. But maybe I read a chapter or two. I kind of want to finish the book, but at the same time not, because I know what's waiting. I know, I'm stressed because I'm just waiting for a certain part to happen, and I'm halfway the book. So I'm just, when is it gonna happen?
Thank you.
the last part of the book, and I'm kind of scared because it is the last part of the book, so there's 100 pages left. Not sure if I want to read everything now. I probably will. It is only 11 p.m. If I cry, I will cry. So far, I'm scared, y'all. I'm scared. So I finished the book and I will talk about it tomorrow, because I'm still thinking about what just happened. Oh man. So let's talk about Crooked Kingdom. Now, I'm gonna spoil the book, so if you don't wanna get spoiled, then click out. I will give you 5 seconds. A lot of my friends like Crooked Kingdom better than Six of Crows, but I think for me, I like them both equally. They both have like pros and cons about them. Are they perfect books? No, but for me, they are perfect. I don't want to go like in depth, because like I said, I don't know how to review books. All I want to say is just go read it. But I will leave a link to with Cindy's, I guess, review or her video of Crooked Kingdom that I had put off for the longest time, because I knew that I want to read the book. But I'm gonna go through some of my favorite quotes. I'm obviously not gonna go through them all, because we would be here all day. Okay, so like the page numbers, I will take from this cover. I'm not sure if they're all the same, because some books are smaller than others, but on page 372, he reached out and took Nina's hand. Rylan suddenly felt he was intruding on something private. I'm grateful you're alive, he said. I'm grateful you're beside me. I am grateful that you are eating. She rested her head on his shoulder. You're better than waffles, Matthias Helver. A small smile curled the Fjordan's lips. Let's not say things we don't mean, my love. Okay, so this is... I thought I was ready. Okay, so before I read this book, I knew that Matthias was gonna die. Like, I got that spoiled. I knew that he was gonna die. I didn't know how or when. He gets shot by some dick kid. Oh my god. So this whole scene when, like, he... And then, of course, Nina wants to save him. And just, like, she wants to take pot him. And then he's like, it's not worth it. But it's not worth the risk. It's worth every risk. I have been made to protect you. Even in death, I will find a way. He clasped her hand tight. Bury me so I can go to jail. Bury me so I can take Ruth and follow the water north. I promise, Matthias, I will take you home. Nina, he said, pressing her hands to his hand to his heart. I am already home. Next page, it says, there were twin souls. Soldiers destined to fight for different sides. To find each other and lose each other too quickly. In the next life, then, she whispered. Go, she watched his eyes close once more. Farewell, she said in Fjordan. May Diel watch over you until I can once more. And then chapter 40. Oh, fuck. Matthias was dreaming of her. The storm raged around him, drowning out Nina's voice. And yet his heart was easy. Somehow he knew that she would be safe. She would find shelter from the cold. He was on the ice once more, and somewhere he could hear the wolves howling. But this time, he knew they were welcoming him home. Fuck. I have not cried that much since I read The Song of Achilles, but even then, I didn't read that much. This hurt more than Patroclus dying, and I'm sorry to say, because if you know, The Song of Achilles is my favorite book, but the way he died, it was... Oh, please watch with Cindy's video, because she, or they, I'm sorry, I don't know their pronouns, they said that, like, his death had a lot of symbolism, and they will explain it way better than me. I'm really glad that I came, I guess, into this fandom now, because now I have so much like fan art, fanfics, and just a lot of like content I can go through. There's so many videos I can go through to fill the void inside my heart. I honestly don't know what else to say. Please go read the books. Yeah. Ugh. I guess that's it for this video. I'm not sure if this was entertaining or not, funny or not. But will I do this again? Maybe till next time. I'm gonna look at fanfics. But thank you guys so much for watching this video. I hope you guys have a good day, good evening, good night, wherever you are. And I'll talk to you soon. Bye.